by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by annual financial support from viewers like you.
These beautiful ripe sliced nectarines are going to end up in this upside down nectarine
lemon chiffon
cake done for us by Mayor Birkin of Spago, and I'll give you back your nectarines.
Okay, we'll set these over here.
That's going to be good, I think.
Okay, and then to save a little time, we're going to put 4 tablespoons of butter right into this pan. And then if you could turn that on for me over a low heat. And then as soon as that's all melted, we'll put a cup of dark brown sugar. You can use either brown or light brown.
Dark brown has some interesting molasses taste.
Right, and it also gives a little more color to the top. And I always use salted butter. What about you?
Always. Is this a springform pan?
It is. It's a 10-inch springform pan. You can use a regular cake pan for this.
Mm-hmm. You're going to unmold it anyway.
Right. And the springform makes it a little easier. So that's nicely melted, and then we'll just take it off the stove, and then crumble in a cup of brown sugar. Here we have it all.
I love the smell of brown sugar, too.
Brown sugar, butter, melted butter.
Mm-hmm. Nothing wrong with that.
Okay. So now we have that nicely packed in there. Then I'm going to take a piece of aluminum foil, set it down on the table, and then put my pan right on top of that.
This is in case it leaks.
Right. All we have to do is unmold it, take the ring off, flip it over.
Mm-hmm.
Easy pie or easy cake.
Yeah.
And we're going to put the nectarines in a concentric circle. Would you like to help me do that?
Sure.
I'll start this way, go around that side.
I'm putting it too upright, I think.
If you don't have completely ripe nectarines, it's okay because this takes about 40 minutes to bake, and the juices from the nectarines will come out, and also the help of the butter and the sugar make them nice.
I'm not making mine as neat as yours.
Well, we'll give you that piece when you go to eat.
All right.
We can get a little fancy and put the next layer in the opposite direction.
Mm-hmm. That's very decorative.
Only we'll know the difference, right? No. When this gets cut up, nobody will know that we put this
much in. Presentation is nice, though.
Okay, so now we have this all prepared, and we're going to set this aside,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to make the streusel that goes inside of that.
Well, now, that's a layer halfway up.
Right, it's kind of like a coffee cake combination. Wolfgang would call this, something that you make me for breakfast, is what he would say about this cake. But actually, you can serve this, you know, after any dinner or luncheon or anything. Now, also, over there, we have a pan of toasted skin-on almonds. Now, a lot of people can't figure out when these are ready because they're already golden brown.
No.
So what I do is when they come out of the oven,
eat one.
Take a bite.
Yeah.
And then you can see on the inside that it's nice and brown.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what we're going to do is put this 1/4 cup of almonds right into the processor. And then to that we're going to add 1/3 cup of flour. And this recipe calls for AP flour. And you want to make sure that you have a nice level 1/3 cup. And then we're going to go and get 4 tablespoons of brown sugar.
More brown sugar, good.
Right. And again, dark light.
Or you could use 1/4 cup.
Exactly. Why didn't I think of that? Right. Okay. And then we have some cinnamon to go in there. And then we need 1 teaspoon of brown ginger. And then we will add to that 4 tablespoons of cold butter. And the reason you want to use cold butter is because it blends in a little bit better.
But you don't want it to end up like mush.
We want it to be crumbly in texture. And then we're also going to put in 1/2 cup of quick oats.
Meaning it's just kind of oat that you can make oatmeal out of.
Right. Or oatmeal cookies.
Yeah. And that's
it. Then we're just going to process that for a few minutes. Now, you don't keep it on the whole time because you don't want the moisture of the butter to really make it stick too much. And it also, if you notice, it gets a little darker in color as the butter starts incorporating into it. Okay, then we're just going to take this off, and we're going to reuse that same pan, spread it right on there. And personally, I like a few big crumbs.
Mm-hmm.
So all you have to do to make those big crumbs is just squeeze it together.
Oh.
And just break that up just ever so slightly.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're going to bake it in a 350-degree oven for about 10 to 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. And about halfway through, I like to take a spatula, kind of push this over into the center so the outside doesn't get too dark.
It's like making granola, isn't it?
Very similar to granola.
Oh, there.
Okay, we'll just put that in the center of the oven, too, is a good place.
Now it's time for the chiffon cake batter. I haven't had a chiffon cake for a goon's age.
You know, I really enjoy making them because they're really versatile. We have a cup of granulated sugar. I'm using a half cup measure right now. Make sure it's nice and level. And then we have a cup of all-purpose flour. And one of the reasons we sift for this recipe is because you want to make sure that it stays nice and light. Now, we also have a teaspoon of baking powder that we're going to add right into that. We have a teaspoon baking soda, and we're just going to get that all nicely sifted and set that aside. Now, since I do use kosher salt in this and it can't go through the sieve, I just go ahead and add that right on top.
Salt.
I find that it doesn't have that really intense salt flavor.
Oh.
And it melts quite well. That is a quarter of a teaspoon.
A quarter of a teaspoon.
Okay, and then we're just going to make a nice little sleeve,
set
that aside, and then we're going to crack our eggs. We're going to separate four eggs, and then we're going to add an extra two egg whites.
Uh-huh. Now, do you have any tricks about the whites?
Well, I always like to keep the shell, go back and forth, and also colder eggs are easier to separate because the yolk stays intact.
Mm-hmm. So you have...
I have four yolks over there, and now we're going to... six whites in here, and then we also have a half a cup of vegetable oil. You can use vegetable oil or safflower oil.
What's we got there?
And then we have a half cup of fresh squeezed lemon juice. And then what we're going to do is we're going to whisk this together,
mm-hmm.
and then we're going to beat the whites.
Yeah.
Now we have a half a cup of sugar to go into those whites, and if you could beat those,
mm-hmm.
just whisk those up.
They just need to be mixed.
I just want to mix them up a little bit. Okay, and then you're going to whisk. I'm going to pour in the dry ingredients.
Okay.
And you want to, this is a good buddy project. You want to do this with a friend, so always invite somebody over.
Always let your
makes your life
friends.
A lot easier.
It's getting thick.
And the reason that you do this gradually is so that it doesn't pick up too quickly.
Yeah, it really has to pick up a lot.
And we're just going to keep that aside, and then we're going to beat the egg whites. You know, what I like to do is I like to start off egg whites at a low speed,
mm-hmm.
because then you get a lot of volume. And now once they get to a soft texture,
mm-hmm.
you want to add in gradually the half cup of granulated sugar. Now you can see it's almost the texture of softly whipped cream.
Mm-hmm.
We're just going to go a little bit further than that.
And the sugar gives it,
it a shine. It gives stability.
Mm-hmm.
This looks a good time to test. What you want to do is you want to make nice soft peaks. I always tell people when I'm teaching classes that you want to be able to run your finger right through. It doesn't cave in,
mm-hmm.
and it also doesn't separate.
Okay. Well, that's beautiful. It's sort of holding its shape nicely.
You know, and it doesn't go anywhere when you tilt the ball.
That's great.
Okay, so what we want to do now is we want to put a little bit of the whites into the batter, just to lighten it up, and then we'll put the batter back into the whites. And then you want to gently fold. Fold and always fold in the same direction. Otherwise, it defeats the purpose, right?
I think it's one of the most important parts of
mm-hmm.
this kind of baking, isn't mm-hmm. it, to make sure you haven't deflated them.
And at this point, you want to work fairly rapidly, but you want to be very gentle and careful with it.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what you want to look for. You want to see some volume in there. Mm-hmm. You want to see the softness. Mm. If it's too liquid, chances are the egg whites weren't quite whipped enough.
No.
Okay. And we will get our prepared nectarine pan. We want to put about half of the batter in there.
Oh, that's beautiful the way it folds in there, isn't it?
Okay, and I'm going to spread that out a little bit to get into the corners. And then we'll sprinkle our toasted streusel on that. And I like to save a little bit of the streusel to sprinkle around the edges of the plates.
That's a good idea, yeah.
And now we're going to put the rest of the batter.
I can do that for you.
Oh, thank you.
It'll help.
You want to make sure that you get all of your batter into that. And then we'll just gently spread the rest of this over here.
Mm.
So now we can bake it.
Okay.
350 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
About 35 to 40 minutes.
Good. Well, I will the oven for you.
Thank you very much. See how our cake is doing. Let's do a halfway test.
Yeah, okay.
Now the color is great.
Yeah.
The color is exactly what it's going to be when mm-hmm. it's done. The only thing that you'll see is that it won't jiggle this much.
It really does jiggle like
it
a custard,
does.
Doesn't it?
And the cake tester, when it is done, will come out nice and clean.
So it has about another 20 minutes.
20 minutes to go. Yeah. Over here, we do have one that's already cooled for 25 minutes, mm-hmm. and I have this nice little cake round, which yeah. makes you nice and easy. And then we'll take off the aluminum foil, and then we'll just flip it over. Maybe you can hit that. That's great.
Mm-hmm.
Right down here on the hand. Take this off. Just take a little knife and help yourself off with the top.
Oh, that looks lovely.
Doesn't that look good? Would you like to try some?
I certainly would.
Okay.
Oh my, that smells so good.
Doesn't it?
Look at all those juices. Mmm. That's nice.
I love cake and fruit together, don't you?
Mm-hmm. And then I think that's streusel in the middle.
Streusel layer in the center.
Look at that.
Okay, and then what I like to do is put a nice dollop of whipped cream on top of that. Good sized dollop, wouldn't say?
Right on the top, yes.
And then we'll take a little bit more of the streusel.
Mm-hmm.
That right on top. Mm-hmm. You can fan these on the side.
Mm-hmm.
The nectarines.
Well, that's a good idea.
Or
reveals.
If you like a little architecture to your dessert.
That's lovely.
What do you think?
Mmm. I like that very much.
Good.
Thank you very much, Jerry.
Very welcome.